Let's put aside the org mode for a moment, and let's talk about some other packages. There's still plenty to cover in org mode. We will get back to it. But just to make it more diverse, I would like to show you some other things in Emacs and in Doom. Today, I will be talking about Magit, or Magit, which is an Emacs UI to Git. And Magit, this is not only my favorite Emacs package. The org mode is just slightly below, but Magit is still the best package I've seen so far. It is also one of the best pieces of software I've seen as a programmer in general, not only in Emacs, but in every aspect. And the reason is that Magit has plenty, just plenty of small things done right. And it feels so natural that working with it, using this tool, is a pure joy. And hopefully, I will be able to transfer my joy of using Magit to you in the course of this and the next and few next episodes. But as always, we will start simple. We will start slowly just to get the intuition. Magit is a package which is already included in Emacs Doom, and it's also already configured for you. So you can just start using it right away. There is nothing to do. The first thing we will do, and the most important thing in Magit, is to show the status page. And you are doing that by pressing space GG. And here you can see, at a glance, all the information needed for you to decide which changes should be included in the next commit. Where are you in the relation regarding the branches and remote branches and so forth? So there are a few sections here. The first one shows you the where's your head at, the remote location. Optionally, you can also have a tag. Then you have a list of untracked files, if you have such files in your repository, unstaged changes, and also a list of recent commits. And those sections will evolve through the next episode. So I will show you how we can even have more information on this status page. So most Magit commands are done from this page, from the status page. And if you are not sure what to do, you can always press the question mark and Magit will show you all the possibilities you can take from this stage. But for now, we don't need that, so I'm pressing Q to close that window. And let's switch to the command line to compare it with our regular Git usage. We are in the same repository. And in order to see the status, we need to use the status command. As you can see, the information here is already lacking compared to what we've seen in Magit. I only see the stage of each file, so I can only see which files are staged, which are not staged but modified, and which are untracked. Magit's status page contains more information. If I'm using the command line, I'm not using this particular status, I'm using status short, which I bound to S. It only shows me the status of each file in a concise way. And now if I would like to see what the changes are there inside those files, I need to use git diff, and then I can go through those changes. Or if I would like to go through those changes and stage them as well, I could use git add p. So I won't dive into that too much, but the idea is that now git will ask me if I want to stage this hunk or chunk or not, and I can go through them in a sequential way. So I have to, if there is a part of a file I want to stage that is at the bottom, at the end of this list, I will have to go through all those pieces of code, press N not to stage them, and at the end press yes. So it's a kind of cumbersome to some extent. So let's go back to Emacs. And let's try to do the same way here. So as I said, each of those sections can be opened and closed using the tab key. but you can also press the tab on a file. And now you are seeing the changes inside those files right from the status page, just by pressing tab. I also see what will be added, what will be committed if I committed those files. So that's already better, and it's more convenient to use it this way. But if I would like to add some changes, I can just press S to stage this particular change. And now this change is already staged for commit. If I change my mind, I can just press U to unstage it. And now I can go to the second or to the last chunk, and I can just decide to stage just that part by pressing S. And now if I open the stage changes, you can see that I'm already have this particular chunk selected. And by pressing U, I'm reverting that decision. If the result of changes spread through a large file, I can fold some changes using the tab key again. So here we did a kind of blasphemy. We combined two poems of two great poets. Let's try to commit this change, commit this profanity, and let me stage all those things. And now if I want to commit it, I can just press C, or if I'm not sure, I can press the question mark. I can press Q to close that window, and now I can commit that. So let's go ahead and do that. I press save, and now I have this commit on the master branch. But it's not a good idea to commit directly to master, but we already did that. But Magit has our back, because we can just press B, branch, and then we can press S, new spinoff. And let's call this branch profanity. So now this commit is on the profanity branch, but if I press L for logs, and again let L, you can see that master is still on the initial commit. So if I'm not sure about this, I can press B again, and instead of pressing S to create a branch, I can just change a branch, switch a branch using B again, and go to master. And now this branch only has this initial commit. Even though we committed this profanity commit to master by using the spinoff branch, BS, Magit rewinded master and applied this commit only to the profanity branch. So that's just a very basic flow. And the next step would be to push those changes to a remote repository. And we will see that in the next episode. That's all for today. May the Emacs force be with you.